Dear colleagues, I'd like to present here the results of our spectroscopic investigations of this, oh, sorry. Of this Herbig-Abbe star. These results are connected with the search for signatures of magnetosphere of this object. Some introduction. Models of magnetically driven accretion reproduce many observational properties of young pre-main sequence stars, T-Tauri stars, with strong magnetic fields of order of thousands Gauss. Applicability of these models to more massive Herbig-Abbe stars is not so obvious because their magnetic fields are an order of magnitude less. Nevertheless, several Herbig-Abbe stars show observational signatures indicating that accretion flows in these stars are guided from the circumstellar disk to the stellar surface by a magnetic field of the star. The scenario of magnetospheric accretion predicts appearance of unhomogeneous accretion streams inside the magnetosphere and high temperature zones on the stellar surface in the regions of its contact with accretion flows. These inhomogeneities rotate rigidly with the star and can modulate the spectroscopic and photometric parameters of the object with a period equal to one or half of rotation period of the star, depending on the number of rotating inhomogeneities. In reality, a diagnostic of magnetospheres is based on the search for periodicity of different observational parameters on a time scale comparable with expected rotational period. As a rule, it is from several to few tens of days. Examples of such investigation are published in a number of papers. In this report, we propose a method allowing to discover signatures of magnetosphere during much shorter time intervals, over one night, especially for fast-rotating stars. It is based on a study of short-term variability of the spectral helium line, which can be an informative indicator of the accretion process onto the star. The object of our study is an isolated Herbig star. It was included in the list of Herbig stars after detection of the far infrared excess. Some parameters of the star are given here. Observations were carried out in two observatories. It is the Kraimen Astrophysical Observatory with 2.6-meter Shine telescope and National Observatory in Ensenada, Mexico in 2.1-meter telescope. Parameters of instrument are given here. 19 spectra have been obtained near the helium line, have been obtained during two nights in Kraimen Observatory, and 8 spectra during one night have been obtained in Mexico. The spectral helium line is forming in the high temperature zone near the stellar surface in the region of interaction of the star with the accretion disk. Its profile looks as an inverse insignia with absorption component originating in the accretion flow near the line of sight. The velocity of the red edge of the absorption indicates the maximum velocity of the flow just before its contact with the stellar surface. This figure illustrates the mean profile of the line obtained in Mexico during one night and a series of individual residuals profiles constructed relative to the mean. The residuals demonstrate no significant variability. This result is expected because the duration of the observational series is too short, about 40 minutes. But the absorption component of the mean profile is very extended. Its red edge achieves more than 400 kilometers per second. So large velocity of the accretion flow can be reached only if the accretion takes place in the free fall regime inside the magnetosphere. So this result can evidence in favor of the presence of magnetosphere in our object. This figure illustrates spectra obtained in Kraimen observatory during two nights. The observational space are longer, and the short-term variability is observed in the form of standing waves on the residuals in the region of the red absorption component. To interpret this phenomenon, we use the analogous phenomenon observed in the line profiles with the signs of stellar wind. This figure, taken from one of our papers, relates to other Herbig stars with this number and its H-alpha line. The short-term variability is seen in the residuals in form of standing waves in the region of the blue Petsigny absorption and a running wave in the central part of the profile. Similar character of variability is often observed in some other Herbig AB stars. Model interpretation of the periods of standing intensity waves on the residual spectra in the region of blue shifted Petsigny absorption has shown that these features form if the surfaces of equal radial velocities serves are orthogonal to the line of sight when it intersects rotating outflowing streams. Such surface orientation is typical for wind with different kinematics. Below we present fragments of figures from several old papers. It is source orientation for accelerated wind, it's wind with deceleration, it is wind with acceleration until some distance and then deceleration plus rotation. Here we give the example of model calculations of the profiles forming in the wind containing a rotating stream at different phases of its rotation. We use the Sobolev's approximation for moving media for calculation of source-south functions and optical thicknesses and exact numerical integration for profile construction. We can see that where the rotating outflowing stream moves near the line of sight, the standing waves and residuals absorbed, and when it is far from the line of sight, the waves are running. The parameters for this particular model are presented in this paper. We can assume that the standing intensity waves on the residuals in the region of the red absorption component of the helium line are originated similarly in those observed in the blue shifted Petsigny absorption component of lines forming in the winds, but the local streams rotate not in outflowing, but in accretion gaseous flows, but this surfs near the line of sight are not orthogonal for this kinematics. It is for Keplerian disk. Keplerian disk plus constant rotation. In all standing waves on the residuals can be seen. The situation is different as we assume that accretion takes place in the magnetospheric regime. In this case, the gas inside the magnetosphere has a specific kinematics. Guided by magnetic field, accretion streams rotate rigidly with the star, and the gas moves towards the star in the free fall regime. We consider the simplest case when the disk is oriented edge on and the magnetic axis lies in the disk plane. The accretion flows are concentrated inside two streams directed towards the magnetic poles. One of them is shown in the figure. In this case, the surface near the line of sight is oriented orthogonally to this line. So the appearance of standing waves on the residuals in the region of the red absorption can be expected. Result of our model calculation confirms this conclusion. We use the model corresponding to our case described on the previous slide. Kinematical parameter of this model is given in this paper. It is simple to dimensional model with south function in the helium line is 1/10 of intensity of stellar continuum. The accretion gas is optically thick in the line. The angle between the accretion stream and the line is changed from minus pi over 2 to plus pi over 2 with a step pi over 12, and the angle of the conic section of the stream is pi over 8. We can see the mean profile and waves on the residuals. We see that this picture is in accordance with our observations. In the general case, spatial and kinematical structure of the magnetospheres has to be much more complex, but a character of surface orientation has to be similar. It's connected with particular kinematics of gas inside the accretion streams. Its radial velocity has to be at the minimum near the outer boundary of the magnetosphere and at the maximum close to the stellar surface because the gas moves in the free fall regime. And its rotation velocity, on the contrary, has to be maximal at the outer boundary of the magnetosphere and minimal near the stellar surface because the stream rotates rigidly with the star. As a result of our investigation, we have made the following conclusions. The existence of magnetosphere in this object is confirmed by a large extension of the red edge of the absorption component of the helium line profile observed in some data. And also it is confirmed by a specific type of the short-term variability of the helium line in the form of standing intensity waves in the region of the red absorption component of the line profile. And at last, we'd like to show the light curve of this object based on the data from the satellite MOST, very exact photometry. The authors argue that the data show a weakly definite cyclic signal with a period of about 1.5 days, which can correspond to rotational period of the star. Such phenomena can be a result of an existence of hot spot on the stellar surface in the region of its contact with the accretion stream moving inside the magnetosphere. Therefore, these results also speaks in favor of our conclusions about the existence of a magnetosphere of this object. Thank you for attention.
I understood that you assumed a joint inclination for MWC. Yes. Okay. So, can you show the third slide with H alpha line profile? Yes. I will ask. Yes. The third. I will ask questions. Then. This is first. Next. Next, sorry. Okay. No, this is helium. H alpha line. Next slide. Sorry. Yes. So, first question: for interpretation of the helium one line for MWC 120 used the wind H alpha line and for another star, another residuals, and this is first question. The next question. We calculated the bracket gamma line profiles and visibilities and differential phase, all interferometric parameters. And this paper is published last year for the star MWC 120. And we showed that we used inclination angle published in the literature, 45, Alex, maybe I am wrong, 45 or 50 inclination angle, yes? Yes, and it is argued with other papers. And why do you know this, I mean not our, or okay, you don't know our results, but maybe other, which is published in literature. Therefore, I have doubts why you used this procedure, this idea at all to compare.
As far as I understand, your question concerns what is the analogy between this picture and our picture then?
Why do you use this method at all? Compare different stars, different lines with different features accreted and form in absolutely different.
It is observations, it is not calculations. We observe, in all observed Herbig stars, in the region of Pitsigny absorption component blue, we can see standing waves on the residuals and running waves in other parts of the profiles. What is the question? Ну что, ну скажи по-русски, я по-английски отвечу.
Почему вы используете метод сравнения аккреционной линии гелия и ветровой линии H-альфа для определения ваших гелий линий для разных звезд при абсолютно неверном угле наклона? Вот два вопроса.
Качество. Qualitatively, the effect not depends on the inclination angle, but phenomenologically, this effect is the same. If we have outflowing streams with inhomogeneous structure, we will see standing waves in blue absorption of Pitsigny. If we have absorption in fall with inhomogeneous structure, we will see standing waves in absorption of helium line. Phenomenologically, this effect is equal. It is not connected with the nature of stars. Yes, it is a phenomenological effect.
Perhaps we can continue the discussion later. Yes. We can move to the next speaker.